Now, Korea wants to develop a supercomputer that can process information up to 5 times faster than AlphaGo, Google's AI system that beat grandmaster Lee Se-dol in a 5-game series of Baduk, or as it's known internationally, Go. For more on Korea's very ambitious goal, Kwon Jang-ho reports.
South Korea's science ministry announced on Monday that over the next 10 years, they'll be investing almost $90 million to develop supercomputers that compete with the world's elite. The ministry aims to accomplish this feat by the year 2020, developing a computer that has a processing speed of 1 petaflop. That's a quadrillion operations per second. To put that into context, the average laptop currently has less than 1 teraflop, or 1/1000th of a petaflop. Even the supercomputer behind AlphaGo is only believed to run on 0.2 to 0.3 petaflops. But in the supercomputer game, Korea has a lot of catching up to do. The first petaflop supercomputer was built by IBM in 2008, and currently the fastest is China's Tianhe 2, which can clock over 33 petaflops. Korea has never built a petaflop supercomputer before, but local scientists are confident that once they create one, they will be able to develop a 30 petaflop supercomputer within the next 10 years. But that's only feasible if their government thinks long term and the funding keeps going for the full 10 years.
There are cases where funding stops midway or the plan changes, but as long as nothing unexpected like that happens, then we should be successful.
Supercomputers traditionally do not have much commercial value, but they can be important for a company or government to become key players in the technology field.
Supercomputers help in the development of servers, PCs, and mobile device technologies. If Korea does not develop and invest in this kind of technology, it could cause difficulties for the country to compete globally in the long run.
Kwon Jang-ho, Arirang News.